Zumba Zumba, my name is David and welcome to another episode of Barbers and Motorcycle brought to you by David's Barbershop. And today I got a special guest. His name is Najee Abdelaziz. He's not only a biker, he's also a barber at David's Barbershop. So stay tuned, let's see what's gonna happen today. Zumba! Barbers and Motorcycle, bro.
Thank you.
So what's going, Najee? We're going to talk today, you know, about the bikes and also about what you do for a living is cut hair. So Najee, when you start riding bikes and motorcycles?
I started riding bikes about 2 years ago.
2 years ago?
Yes.
And so far, how'd that go?
Well, riding bikes are good. I like it. It's a stress reliever. Give me some time to myself.
What about cutting hair? How long have you been cutting hair?
Cutting hair about 5 years now.
5 years?
Yes.
And you like to cut hair, I guess, so, you know. And I also heard you got a new baby.
Yeah.
Hold on, Najee. We used to have a... What did you used to have before the...
I used to have a 2016 Sportster 48.
48?
Now it upgraded to a 2018 Road King Special.
Look at that beauty. 2018.
Smell good.
Oh,
she still smells brand new.
Like brand new. Yeah. Smell like new.
She's only about 2 weeks old.
2 weeks old? Yeah. She's fresh.
It's different
rides between the Sportster and the Road King?
Oh man, it's amazing. Big difference.
You feel like it can? Like the name of the bike?
Oh yes.
Alright, so far. No, what? Tell me a good experience on the Sportster, because I guess you don't got too many good experiences in this one.
I want to say, when you're on a bike, you have to respect that bike. If you do not respect that bike will remind you to respect that bike. Okay? Tell you a little short story. We were riding our Route 80. For those people who don't know what Route 80 is, it's about a six-lane highway here in Hudson County, you know, in the tri-state area. And we were doing getting off the ramp, so I was doing maybe about 25. And I leaned to the right, and then I went to the left without coming back up to the left. And the bike threw me off. And I tumbled.
I remember that day, that was a ninja day. Guys, you don't know, Najee's kind of big, but he got skills. He's like a ninja in an old man's body. I don't know how he do it, but he did it.
When I was younger, I did some martial arts, so I know how to fall. So I tucked and rolled and survived the fall.
So I mean, you ready to be a stuntman in the movies?
Oh, Mike? I don't know, man.
You know about that?
I don't think I want to be doing that. It takes a toll on your body. I give those guys a lot of credit.
No, I see you, and trust me, I was more scared than you. I was stuck in traffic like, what I do? Now, what I do? This is the floor. Oh, he get up. Oh, he lift the bike with one hand. One hand lift the bike. I was like, okay.
Let me tell you, it was one of the most embarrassing moments
in my life. How many days?
The adrenaline was kicking in. I was able to lift the bike with one hand. So,
how many days or weeks take it to, you know, to get over that and get back in the bike and get the confidence back?
I got back up on the bike in 30 seconds. I was gone.
Yo,
man. That's not gonna stop me.
Well, you know how it is.
Close.
That's a couple, man. I'm not trying to.
That's kind of things that happen. It's a barbershop.
Najee, so you went to Daytona big week, past March. Tell me about the experience. How was it?
Daytona was nice. I haven't been riding that long, so the only experience I had to compare it to was when I went to America. But I only went to Americade for like 2 days. And that was a good ride. But Daytona's another thing. If you haven't been there, you gotta try it.
So that's one for this moment on, this is the best experience you have on the bike.
So far.
Was Daytona.
So far. I'm planning.
In the Destiny, I say Destiny. Destiny wise, Daytona was right now. In the moment, is the your favorite Destiny right now. Yeah.
Well, that's the best destination I've had so far. So that was because we got a chance to ride the bikes on the beach.
And you don't got no fun experience as a bobber that you can tell us about that.
Well. Like what? In a barbershop, if anybody knows anything about barbershops, things happen all the time. And you can't plan things in a barbershop. you might have a plan, but it ain't going to turn out that way.
Tell me the scary moments at the barbershop like you've been through. Like you'd be like, oh, shit. Why am I a barber, bro? Like, why I pick this,
this profession?
You got your irate customers, don't like it when you cut their hair and they don't like the way you did it and they start complaining like their hair don't grow back. I've been threatened. That, they're going to shoot up the barbershop, they're going to close us down. But you know what? 4 days later, they come back.
They come back.
They say sorry, huh?
What you gonna do?
And what's your favorite haircut? Because I'm a barber too, so you have to have your favorite haircut. Like you say, this is my favorite haircut I like to do because it's simple, it's fast, and you like to style it or whatever.
I like comb overs with a skin fade.
A skin fade?
I like comb overs with a skin fade.
Why you like the comb overs and the skin fade?
So you're telling me you're good with skin fades.
Well,
I'm a
barber, and I'm sorry to say there's no barber out there that's going to say they're perfect.
So, you're right.
Everybody's always learning.
So I'm going to give you an invitation right now. For maybe not for the next one, but in the future, I want you to be the one cutting the hair. And I see the question. What do you think about that?
I don't mind.
You down for that?
I can do that.
Guys, he said it. Soon, you will see Najee cutting hair here too. Because it's going to be part of Barbers and Motorcycle. We want to let the barbers who rides and the barber... who do not ride, they come here and show their skills too. And like right now, I'm doing to him a skin brook with a nice comb over, make it look good. Like that, when he get to that bike, he can, take that helmet off wherever he go. And then other people, I'm fresh.
I got another good question for Naeed.
What's that?
What motivated you to be a barber?
What motivated, let's see. I'm 43 years old now. When I was about 35, I started cutting my kids' hair. And I noticed that I like doing it. And being in a barbershop, I have more time to myself, more time to my family, less time out there working. Because I don't feel like it's a job. I like what I'm doing, so I like coming to work.
You know a lot, right? You got any questions for him? You can ask something.
Barbers.
Here we go.
let me say something. Bikers, please. There's no reason to look scruffy. We're here. There's plenty of barbers all over the world. Get your hair cut. You don't have to look messy. We're trying to change the image. Yeah. People keep thinking that that bikers are dirty. They're bums. They look old. We don't want to do that anymore. We want to change the game. Exactly. We want people to understand that bikers are human beings too. They just like to ride a bike.
Yeah. All right, my boy, I got a question for you.
What's your name again?
Najee.
You say you've been riding almost 2 to 3 years now.
About 2 years now, yes.
What made you go to ride bike now at that age, that long time in age? And what was your first bike?
Well, my first bike was the Sportster 48. I started riding, when I was younger, I lost people that rode motorcycles, and I never wanted to ride a bike. But as I got older, I got over that, and I wanted to try it. And the freedom of being on the road, it's a good feeling. You get the wind in your hair, you forget about all your worries because you're concentrating on the road. And it's a stress reliever. You get to forget about everything else and just have fun.
All right.
So how do you get a balance between being a barber that you like so much and being a rider? How do you balance that with your personal life?
Well, I ride when I can. I ride to work, I ride out of work, and whenever I have time, I ride. But coming to work is number one. You got to work to be able to afford to have the bike.
Especially a bike like the Rokin. The Rokin is a bike. It's a touring bike. It's a very comfortable bike. We don't know about the Rokins. And it's a, like I call it, it's a king bike. It's, that bike is, when you take.
And plus, that got a new engine, Milwaukee 8. Yeah. So, I mean, that bike is fast.
No vibration. Very fast.
So, I got a question for Najee again.
What's up?
Taspi, Najee, tell me about this Taspi.
Like I said.
I want to hit a three-digit number.
Now when you hit that three-digit number, the floor, this monster.
No, he's a good interviewer.
Like, remember, his wife is going to be listening to this.
Yeah. No, I know.
Like I said, I have a new rider. I'm still a fresh rider.
The question is, do you touch the three digits or not?
No.
Najee,
I touch 3 digits.
You sure? 3 digits?
Really? I'm positive.
I don't know, man.
I don't know. They told. I think I got a video. I don't know. Somebody passed flying next to me. I don't know.
I've gotten up to at least 85, 90, but I have not hit 3 digits yet.
It's hard to control. No. 3 digits.
Well, I've only had the bike 2 weeks. And the Sportster vibrates too much. It's not nice to go 100 miles an hour on a Sportster. Not that it can't be done.
I don't recommend it. Calix got a question there, man.
In case something happened to you, like what happened with your other bike, are you be a better one to lift this bike with one hand?
Well, no.
You never know. He's a ninja, bro. Remember,
exactly.
He didn't take much hard. This is what I see when I stop the traffic. Just do this shit. Get in the bike. I run to him. Najee, you okay?
When the adrenaline kicks in, who knows?
Behind.
He might be able to.
Standing behind me on the turnpike. I mean, like, what am I gonna do now?
Listen, I saw you the other bike. Mm-hmm. Not for nothing. Got some weight. This one probably have more. But the way they're telling me you lift with one hand, it's most impossible. Especially in the middle of the highway.
It's a couple man. Listen, it's a couple of 100 miles.
I wish and I would pay to be there in that moment. Because
you don't want to be there. You don't want to be there in that moment. I was there and my heart was like, you know what I do? Can I go to the bike or what? I was stopping the traffic. I looked back. The lady was like,
nah, you know what the funny thing?
Oh, what happened? No.
The funny thing about all this, right, is like, we was on the way to one of the dealers, right? And we get to the dealer, and the only thing he complained about was my jacket. My jacket's broke. And I'm like, yo, so you telling me
my favorite jacket?
He scratched his pipes. He broke one of the handlebars and thing, and he just cared about the jacket. Like, my dude, that's a $25 jacket.
This could be replaced, but my favorite jacket, man, bro.
Yo, the store went out of business. So I can't buy the jacket no more.
Good jacket, man.
Yo, nah, but you know, like every episode we try to acknowledge the people about why you can tell the people like who's not motorcycle riders when they in the street, like
what type of experience,
like what the message you want to give them to them.
Message. Yeah.
Well, for the riders, I want to say please respect your bike. Doesn't matter how fast you can go. You're doing 20 miles an hour or 120 miles an hour. A fall from a bike can still hurt. Either way, for the people who don't ride bikes and you're out there and you're seeing people doing things on the bike, a lot of times they have a reason for what they're doing. The bikes, you need traction, so you have to warm up the tire. So you'll see them swerving. You'll see them swerving because a bike, you have to warm up the whole tire, not just the bottom of the tire. That's it, give them some room. We, you know, our peripheral vision on a bike is not as easy as a car. You got a whole bunch of mirrors. We just got 2 mirrors, and most of the time we can't see over our shoulders. We're just seeing what's on the side of us. So we got our blind spots too. Give us a little room and we'll get out of your way.
Okay, helmet or no helmet?
Well, of course, if you want to be safe, you should be wearing a helmet. But have I ridden without a helmet? Yes.
Experience is great, right?
It's a different experience. It's fun.
That's when you feel free for real. That's the real free ride. Guys, you never ride the bike in Florida or places you don't need a helmet to drive.
For us, Pennsylvania is one of the close by states that you don't have to ride a helmet.
You can try. Go over to PA, drive your bike without a helmet at least. Don't try to go fast, 40, 35. You will feel free. That's so. Experience like nobody can tell you how to feel. You need to do it because that's crazy. That's something else. That's
obviously if you're cruising and you're just
cruising.
Enjoying your ride, no helmet, I would recommend it. Try it out. But But if you out there trying to do wheelies and go fast, wear a helmet. Wear a helmet.
Wear a helmet, yeah.
In case you hit that ground, your skull will break.
So, Najee, thank you very much for everything, Najee.
Thank you very much.
And like every video we make, we're going to try to tell the people, look twice, save a life, and watch for the bikers, so please. You know? And remember, Barbershop Motorcycle brought to you by Davis Barbershop. See you in the next episode.
Zumba! Zumba. Boom, 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 boom.